anybody else going stir crazy at the minute? Who would have thought, like, at the start of the 20s in the 21st century, we'd all be starring in our own personal horror film? Crazy, crazy times. It means, for those of us who like to get out into the wilds, up mountains, into woods, it's a little bit difficult. So to try and offset that, I've decided to come into the garden, into the wilds of the garden. Picked up some spaghetti bollock naked earlier, as you've seen, it was rather tasty. And I'm just relaxing and enjoying the heat from the wood burning. Great job, those. They are the Outbacker original stove. It's basically just a Frontier stove rebranded. But oh, I give up some lovely heat. The reason I'm wearing the hat, it's not particularly cold tonight. It's a bit of a chill. There's stars are out, but the reason I'm wearing the hat is I attempted to cut my own hair, which did not really go too well. You can imagine a dog with mange. That's how my hair is looking at the minute. So, you're all in the same boat, unless you're married to a hairdresser. Or you have a hairdresser in the family. Well, again, if your hairdresser is your niece or your auntie or your uncle or whatever, they can't come and see you, cut your hair. You can't go and see them. Unless they live in the same house, then you're elected. But I actually tried. I was in Sainsbury's earlier on there, and actually was having a look out for clippers, but sold out. They were sold out because people anticipated that they're not going to go to the hairdressers. So it's DIY. So I think if I do get my hands on a set of clippers, I'm just going to go the whole through this job and shave the whole lot off and just let it grow back evenly, because see at the minute, that deer skin rug, that deer skin rug looks better. Anyway, plans for 2020 in the wild camping have taken a bit of a setback, as I'm sure everybody else has. I had planned Rafflin Island and the north side near the West Lighthouse. Some beautiful sea sticks there. I'm going to get the drone up, get a bit of footage, a few pickies. That's hit my head. Only islanders are allowed. Well, that's right there anyway. You're not allowed to go anywhere. Everybody's locked down. But, yeah, well, only islanders are allowed on and off. But I can't see that being allowed now. You're on, you stay there. And I think there are arrangements made to get their groceries and orders and fuel and stuff ferried over. But yes, there are rather strange times we're living in. Like this coronavirus, I mean, it's, if you look at it realistically, it's 50-50. Either you catch it and die, or you catch it and don't die. And if you don't die, there's probably various levels of severity. Some people who catch it, the majority actually who catch it, show mild cold symptoms, flu symptoms. Severe cases, like a very bad flu. And if you are really, really unlucky, happy, you'll need the ventilator to help you breathe, as it's a respiratory condition. Affects the lungs, your body floods the lungs with mucus, and you basically drown in your own fluids. So you have to drain your lungs and breathe for you artificially. The problem being is that all those who have not adhered to government guidelines of staying home, keeping distance, washing hands, those who know better increase the likelihood of quite a lot of population who have got the virus presenting at the same time, and that is the problem. When the curve, you hear this curve they're talking about, and the curve goes way up like that there, and way up and round and down. So that area inside that curve represents an overwhelmingly high number of people who need ventilators in the worst case scenario. And there's not enough. So if you go and you take really bad, and you go into hospital, and all the ventilators are being used, basically you put into a side ward, you're given palliative care, and you die. That's how serious this is. Now, the best way that we can help the NHS is to stay at home. Do not go near anyone. And what that'll do to the curve is bring it down low, like that. Still the same amount of people who are going to be affected, but they're coming in presenting gradually. In other words, the infection is peaking. Not everybody goes at once. You have that many going at once compared to that many going at once. It's manageable, but we can see the immense pressures that the NHS are under in England at the minute. There's an average of 600-700 per day. It's crazy numbers, crazy numbers. Of course, here in Northern Ireland, we have the added bonus that the amount of PPE we have at the minute for our NHS workers is about to run out, and there's no prospects. This is Saturday, 4th, 5th, Saturday, and as of yesterday, there was no prospect of getting any more in. We're due to peak next week. Basically, everybody who's got it is going to present with between mild and severe, and the state above severe, requiring ventilating. And what happens in an ICU ward when the nursing staff do not have the personal protection equipment to look after you? It doesn't bear thinking about. Strange times that we are living in. Here I am having a ramble, which is usually about gear or about spots of pain or plans that we're talking about a world pandemic. It's killing people. Crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. So I'm sure a lot of you have got plans for when this is eventually over. Comment below. Doesn't necessarily have to be camping or wild camping or bushcraft in nature. If you just If you just like watching the channel, just comment below what your plans are when this is over. Had you a holiday planned that had to be cancelled? Do you intend to go back again? Do you intend to travel more? It's funny, like, when we come out the other side of this, hopefully all my family and friends come out the other side of it. Things are not just going to be the same, in so much as I think can't take anything for granted anymore. And when we do come out the other side, which we will do, it's a sort of a wake-up call, isn't it? Really. Live every day like it's your last. You never know. Go on that holiday. Conquer that mountain. Go to that wild spot in a forest that's miles and miles and miles and miles away from you. Just do it. Who knows what's around the corner? Nobody knows what's around the corner. But I know since there have been curfews like everybody else, I crave being out in nature. I need that connect. I need to be in a forest. I need to be in a wild place. Listen to the birds, listen to the wind and the trees. I need it. It's like a drug. And I know I'm talking for most of you. You know, I suppose in one way I'm lucky enough, I live in the countryside, a small farm. And I don't know how people cope in the city. I go stir crazy all together. I go for down around the fields, my own fields. And I still have a reasonable connect. But yeah, anybody in the city, I feel for you. I definitely do. Nice night tonight. Stars are out. Moon is out. Waking gibbous. Nothing's nice, it's just a bit of a breeze all the time too, as you could probably hear. A bit of a breeze. Even the trees are dancing. So basically I'm just going to sit out, enjoy the evening. It's nearly midnight. Just relax. I finished this bottle of wine there, I have a nip of whiskey left. Listen to the sounds of the wind in the trees. Watch the stars. Funny, in the woods though, I don't actually have, well, I started a little bit with kindling. And put a couple of sticks in that I gathered around the garden from branches and whatnot that had fallen off the tree. Last orders. But I've actually put in peat briquettes, so you get that lovely country smell of the turf, that turfy smell, and it's really, really lovely, and it burns nicely, you know, it's It's a nice steady heat, mate. That is roasting. I can feel the heat actually from here. I mean, okay, we're coming into the summer. We're on lockdown. This will probably be the best summer we've had in years since the last good summer. It'll be a crazy. Everybody will be going stir crazy. I guarantee you the weather will be fantastic. And us wild campers will be biting at the bit, going crazy. But for the foreseeable future, see the back garden. I was going to, and what I will do is, those of you who know me, I keep sheep. And the field in the front of the house, there's a flat field. I was going to stick up about 5 or 6 tents I've got. And actually Ben suggested this, but I was going to stick up all the tents and just go around them and make it look like a little campsite. And, maybe do a wee bit of a review on each of the tents that I've held on to, I've kept and I use. This is the recent acquisition, the Smokry Hut by One Tigris, it's great. There's plenty of room. It's a palace for one, two, no problem with that, but all the glamping accessories, but we have a mat here, mat over there, roughly in the middle there, the fire, and pull the door down, and plenty of heat. In the winter, yes, perfect, but coming into the warm nights, it's not such a good idea. There we go, I was going to talk about plans I had and kit I was going to use in the spring summer season. Last orders again, a wee bit of a breeze. But that's all scuppered at the minute. The wife, she's working from home. Which is handy. Good for having to go into the office. I'd probably go under her a bit more, hope she gets under my maybe. more tea vigor. A little red tonight. Well, I only drink red wine, I don't drink white wine. I used to drink white wine. I don't know if I was sick enough at one time, I think it was too sweet or something, I don't know. But I started on a couple of nice reds, and I haven't looked back. Ben, he's a beer man. Like, I like beer too, don't get me wrong. The old Coors Light. It's hard to get a nice cold, crisp lager in the summer. But yeah, I like red wine. I think it's a prerequisite of, well, for me anyway, it's a prerequisite of a camp life. Nice bottle of single malt scotch, Bushmill, the Talisker, Glenmorangie, and a bottle of red. I don't want to give the impression that I'm an alcoholic. I would maybe have a couple of glasses of wine at camp, but I don't get absolutely rudderish, unlike Ben, who gets absolutely rudderish. But, sorry, mate. Yeah, for the new subscribers, thank you very much. Channel's starting to grow a bit. Okay, so thanks very much for watching, and if you've got this far, well done. If you haven't already, I would appreciate it if you subscribe and like this sort of thing. And hit that like button, hit that bell, etc, etc, all that good stuff. I'll talk to you very soon on the next one. Meanwhile, look after each other, look after yourselves, stay at home, stay safe,
Fuck that.